Sipping on a whiskey when I got the call. Yeah, my friend Lex was lying in the hospital. She'd been pretty sick for about half a year, and it seemed like this time the end was drawing near. So I packed my bag and dropped the next London train. Found her laid up and in a lot of pain. Her eyes met mine and then I understood that the weather forecast, it wasn't looking good. So I sat and spun her stories for a little while. Tried to raise her mood and tried to raise her smile, but she silenced all my ramblings with a shake of her head. Drew me close and listen, this is what she said now. You live to dance another day. Now you'll have to dance for the two of us. So stop looking so damn depressed and sing with all your heart. Queen is dead, yeah. She told me she was sick of all the hospital food. Doctors, sisters, relatives, bringing her blood. She said, I know I'm dying, but I'm not finished just yet. And I'm dying for a drink and for a cigarette. So we hatched a plan to book ourselves a cheap hotel in the center of the city and to raise some hell. Lay waste to all the clubs, and then when everyone else was asleep, you know we're good and done. You live to dance another day. Now you'll have to dance for the two of us. So stop looking so damn depressed and sing with all your heart. The queen is dead. And South London's not the same anymore. The queen is dead. The last of the greats has finally gone to bed. Well, I was working on some words when Sarah called me up. She said that Lex had gone to sleep and wasn't waking up. And even though I knew that there was nothing to be done, I felt bad for not being there, 'cause well, now she was gone. So I tried to think what Lex would want me to do at times like this when I was feeling blue. So I gathered up some friends to spread the sad, sad news, and we headed to the city for a drink or two, and we sang. We live to dance another day. One more of us. So stop looking so damn depressed and sing with all our hearts. Lord.